Hello, all of you able to see the screen and my voice is audible to all? अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ एंड टेल। दांगट पूजा। हाँ
यस सर।
प्रेजेंटेशन इज विजिबल।
यस
ओके सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। सो एक्चुअली इन लास्ट वीक वी हैव स्टार्टेड सिलेबस। इन फर्स्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द ओवरव्यू ऑफ द सिलेबस। What is the prerequisite of this subject? Then what are the objectives? What are the outcomes? Then we have seen actual syllabus, which are the six units. In that you have to see some theory related to software testing, then manual testing, automation testing, then software quality assurance that you have to see. Also we have seen which are the books you have to refer. So in syllabus they have mentioned some textbooks and some reference books. Then in last week we have seen which are the types of testing. Majorly there are two types, manual testing and automation testing, that we have seen in detail. In manual testing you have to test the application manually, so it takes lot of efforts in terms of time and lot of peoples are required to test in manual testing. But in automation you use some tools and you write a script in that tool and that script tests the application. We don't have to test it manually. That script and tool does the job. So which are the tools we have seen? In last lecture we have seen Selenium automation tool. So Selenium is open source test automation tool which is used worldwide. After that we have seen two types of testing approaches, black box testing and white box testing. We have seen that difference. What is that? So black box testing has another name, behavioral testing or structural testing, and white box testing, it is also called as glass box testing. So what happened in black box and white box? In black box testing, if we don't have the internal knowledge, we don't need the internal knowledge of the code. We just have to know the what is the input we have to give and what is the output we want. If this application give correct output, then we can say that test is pass or test is failed. So like that, we just give input and we check the output in black box testing. But in white box testing, that tester must have internal knowledge of the code, and tester checks how that code behavior, how that code does job, it does job that correct or not. So in this way we test the code using two approach, black box testing and white box testing. Then in that lecture we have seen some quality principles. So in that we have seen Ishikawa's seven basic tools. So that ask in exam. So you have to explain that seven tools question for 6 to 7 marks. So for each tool you have to explain what is scatter diagram, what is histogram, what is Pareto chart. So that each you have to explain. So in this lecture we will see software testing and quality assurance. In that we see how we can give quality to the software. So pattern you already know, 70-30 pattern, 30 marks in semester based on first 3 units and end semester exam of 70 marks. So in this lecture, we will see quality management. So how you can incorporate better quality in the software. So in that we see software quality assurance. Then which are the elements of software quality assurance? Then which are the tasks which are associated with software quality assurance? Which are the goals of SQA? What are the metrics? Then Six Sigmas for software engineering. Then ISO standards, ISO 9000 quality standard. Then quality management principles. Then SQA plan. So this we will see one by one. So first is the software quality assurance. It is acronym as SQA. So what is that? It is the process in software development life cycle that checks the developed software meets the desired quality or not. So what is SQA? जेव्हा आपण सॉफ्टवेअर बनवतो तेव्हा ते सॉफ्टवेअर एका लाईफ सायकलमधून जातं, सॉफ्टवेअर डेव्हलपमेंट लाईफ सायकल, SDLC. सो ॲट द टाईम ऑफ डेव्हलपमेंट SQA checks that software having the qualities which has given by the customers or which we have written on paper in requirements. So this is nothing but the software quality assurance. In that we see the different measures. So in SQA we test the quality of software in each phase of the development until the software is complete. So what we does when software is developed, it develops in different modules, we know that. So when first module is developed, we check the quality, what is the job of this module and it meets the requirement or not. So till when we test that, till the software is fully integrated, that until the software is fully complete, till that we do the test and we check that software having the good quality. Then which are the activities are involved? So first is the process definition and implementation. So process definition means what? We do the module definition. We divide our software into different modules. When we run that module, it becomes process. So in assurance, we first check what is the software definition and we check that according to the definition that software is implemented or not. Then auditing of that software, then training. So in each phase we check that software having the quality which we want to incorporate at the end when that whole software is completed. Then what are the objectives of software quality assurance? First, to provide approaches for quality management. So when we have to give good quality to software, there are different approaches. So we have to think on that and we have to provide the particular approach. Then second, to provide mechanism for measuring and reporting defects. So what is second objective? When software is in testing phase, lot of defects that software tester will observe. So So that defects we have to notify to the software developer. So we have to provide some mechanism. So using that, we can check what are the defects are there. Then we can measure the defects are time critical or not. And we have to report to the developer so that that defects will be fixed. So this is the objective. Second, third objective, to provide efficient and effective software engineering process. So in SQA, efficiency is very important. And your software must give the effective solution for the problems. Then fourth one, to provide a procedure to ensure the compliance with software development standard. So SQA must provide the, what is the procedure, what is the method using that that software meets the different standards that in the industry. So that meets the all the standards. Then fifth one, to provide multi-testing strategy. So when you test the software, so there are different strategies are there. Among that, there is multi-testing strategy. So single code can be tested by the multiple test engineers. So we can create a single repository in Git, and multiple test engineers access that code and can test. So in this way, testing happens very fast and efficient manner. And all the defects will be measured and reported efficiently. Then next objective, to take a formal technical review throughout the software process. So at the time of process development, when the first module is developed, then that module must be sent to for testing. And after a testing, you have to take a meeting or the communication between the team, so that the, what is the actual problem, what are the defects, that discussion happens, and it is called as a formal technical review. So getting all of you, these are the six software quality assurance objective. Then next, which are the elements which are associated with SQA? So these are the 10 elements. First is SQA having some standards. In SQA, we give some reviews, we audit. Then in SQA, testing happens rigorously. In SQA, errors and defects are collected and analysis is happen. Then fifth is the change management. Sixth is the education. Then seventh, vendor management. Seventh, eighth, security management. Then in SQA, safety is also measured. Ninth, safety. And last, tenth is the risk management. So that all the elements will be taken care in SQA. These are the elements of SQA. Then what are the jobs or what are the tasks which are associated with SQA? First is the prepare plan for the project. So I have already told, when you do testing, you have to create a test case. So same in SQA, when you think about the quality, then you also prepare the SQA plan. So how you incorporate the different qualities in your software. Second, participate in the development of the project's software process description. So second task is the all the team members must involve in the phase of SQA and develop the software process description, how that plan is going to be executed. Third, review software engineering activities to verify compliance with the defined software process. So when we create a plan, when we discuss among the team members, third is the we have to review our plan. So check that all the activities are okay with respect to software engineering and all activities are well defined or not. So after this task, we do auditing. Then after auditing, there is a document procedure. And last is the record evidence of non-compliance and report them to management. So these are the tasks involved with the SQA. First, the prepare the plan. Second, discuss with the teammates. Third, review that plan. Then audit. Then create the document of that plan and report that to the management of the company. So this is the table. In that, quality assurance goal is given and its attributes. So first goal is the requirement quality. So in requirement quality, what are the problems you face? So that are there ambiguity. So what is the ambiguity? So one statement having different meanings. So that in that requirement, you have to remove the ambiguity. What actually that customer want, that we have to ask in detail to remove the ambiguity. Second factor is the completeness. Next, volatility, traceability, and model of clarity. So these are the goal attributes in a requirement quality. So that goals happens in what requirement that customer given at the time of requirement phase. Then in design quality, what are the problems we can face and which are the goals we have to achieve? So first goal is the architectural integrity. So first we have to draw the architecture of the software and we have to check that all the components are integrated that fit in that architecture or not. Then we have to check all the components are complete or not. So that is the component completeness. Then third is the interface complexity. And in design, we have to use different patterns, singleton pattern or factory resort pattern that we will see in the next units. But in design, when we draw architecture, so at the time of design, we have to select what is the pattern we have to use. Then third, code quality. So for code, there are some goals that the complexity we have to check whether our code is complex. Then maintainability. So when you create a software, customer want some updation in that. So that is nothing but maintenance. So when we code, we have to check that can this software is maintainable. Then understandability, that code must be understood by all the teammates, because software developers and software testers works in different shifts. So that code must be developed in continuous process. So your code must be understood by all your team members. Then reusability. So in code, we have to use object-oriented features so that code we can reuse. So all of you know that different object-oriented features like inheritance, polymorphism. So that we have to use. Then documentation. When we write some code, we have to give comments so that our team members can understand what is the use of this code, why this method is used, which are the APIs are used. So that's why documentation is also important in SQA. Then last goal is the quality control effectiveness. So in quality control, we see that goals are resources allocation, then completion rate. What is the deadline is given? So in that deadline, that task has happened or not. Then review effectiveness. Then last is the testing effectiveness. So that we check in quality control effectiveness. So these are the goals and these are the problems or properties which are associated with that goal. So getting all of you? Then next, software quality metrics. So software quality metric is divided into three categories. First, product metrics. Second, process metrics. And third, project metrics. So each one we will see one by one. Screen is visible to all. Hello. Are you able to see the presentation?
No, sir.
What was the last point we have discussed? Gaikwad Mayuri, what was the last point we have discussed in presentation? Kadam Ashwini. कल्याणी घोंडगे। कांचन सिद्धनाथ, करिश्मा सिपलकर, टेल मी फास्ट, काटे निकिता, प्रियंका कोलटकर, पूजा शिर्के, संपदा।
हेलो, एसक्यूए टास्क एंड प्रोजेक्ट मैट्रिक्स।
ओके। सो नाउ इट इज विजिबल।
यस सर,
यस सर,
यस सर।
सो दैट मैटर्स इज
यस सर।
ओके। सो दिस सॉफ्टवेयर क्वालिटी मैटर्स are categorized into three metrics. First is the product metrics, second is the process metrics, and third is the project metrics. So we will see each one by one. So first is the product metrics. So what is in product metrics? So in that we see that different properties or characteristics of projects. So which are the characteristics we'll see? What is the size? What is the complexity of this project? Which are the design features are used? What is the performance of that product? And what are the different quality levels in that product? That we will see in product metrics. Then second, process metric. So in process metrics, we check the improvement. What are the improvement in the development of that software? Then which are the maintenance activities that happens in the software process? So these are the process metrics. Then third is the project metrics. So in project metrics, we check the different properties of project, how that project is executed. Then in project metrics, we check that how many software developers are involved in that project. Then what is the life cycle of that software? What is the cost of that software? What is that schedule? What is the deadline of that software? And productivity of that software. So these are the properties or characteristics we check in the project metrics. Then in the quality of the software, there are some standards. So in that, one standard is Six Sigma. So what is Six Sigma? So Six Sigma is a highly definition, highly disciplined process. So that helps to focus on the development and deliver perfect products and services. So getting all of you, what is Six Sigma? It is highly disciplined process. In that particular process is given that we have to follow, and when we follow that process, we get the perfect products. So there will be very less defects. So for this, we have to follow the Six Sigma process. So this Six Sigma is a statistical term that measures how far this process deviates from perfection. So using Six Sigma, you check that your actual product and perfect product, that compares, and it checks is your actual product is perfect or not. Then what is the idea? Why this Six Sigma is developed? What is the idea behind this? So check the, what is the idea? If you can measure how many defects you have in process, you can statistically figure out how to eliminate them and get close to zero defects as possible. What is Sigma? Using create a perfect process and create it. So they have used IDEA using Sigma in your product. There will be almost closely zero defects will be there in your product. And the failure rate of your product is, they have given 3.4 parts per million. म्हणजे तुमचं जो प्रोडक्ट आहे तो फेल होण्याची शक्यता 0.01% पण नसते. सो इफ यू फॉलो दिस प्रोसेस, सिक्स सिग्मा प्रोसेस. सो व्हॉट इज इन सिक्स सिग्मा? सो इन दॅट देर आर थ्री मेथड्स. फर्स्ट इज BPMS. What is BPMS? Business Process Management System. So you have to follow the Business Process Management System. Then what is second? DMAIC. So these are the short forms. So full forms are given in bracket. D for define, M for measure, A for analyze, I for improve, and C for control. So these are the measures that you have to use in the discipline process of Six Sigma. And last is the DMADV. So what is DMADV? D for define, M for measure, A for analyze. Then again, there is DD for design, V for verify the performance. So your process must go through the that three methodologies. When we create the, what is the process of development of product, that must go through the business product management system. When we define the process, we have to measure, then we have to analyze that process is perfect or not, or again there is improvement, we have to check for improvement, and again we have to check the quality control. Again in third, again we have to define the process, we have to measure, we have to analyze, again we have to design, then we have to verify that our design is perfect or not. So if we use these processes of Six Sigma, which are highly disciplined, then our product, our services that are closely to the perfect and failure chances is 0.001%. Then next, what are the benefits? Why this Six Sigma is used in industry worldwide? So there are six major benefits that is given in this slide. First, generate sustained success. When you use this Six Sigma, success is guaranteed. Second, this Six Sigma sets a performance goal for everyone. Then third benefit, enhance value to customer. When your company follows the Six Sigma process, then customer will be attracted and customer has value of your company. Then fourth, accelerates the rate of improvement. So your product of that quality of your product will be improved. There will be less defects. There will be less failures. This is the fourth benefit. Fifth, promotes learning and cross-pollination. So using Six Sigma, your team learns the different metrics related to the software quality. And last is the it execute strategic change. So using Six Sigma, if in runtime you have to change some strategy, you can incorporate that strategy in your process. So these are the six benefits of Six Sigma. So that's why most of the companies use this process, Six Sigma standards. And which are the other standards related to the software quality assurance? So first is the IEEE. So full form is given, IEEE stand for Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers. Then ISO standard. We all know ISO standard, International Organization for Standardization. ISO 9000 standard. Then DoD standard. So this standard is used in USA, US Department of Defense standard. Then ANSI standard, American National Standards Institute. Then IEC standard, International Electrotechnical Communication. Last, software quality. It is concerned with the quality management and quality assurance. When you see that software is having ISO standard, then we ensure that this software having good quality and all the qualities are assured in that software, because that software is of ISO standard. In ISO standard, it deals with fundamentals of quality management. In ISO 9001, the requirement and what is the requirement of organization that will be fulfilled. So now most of the institutes are ISO 9001 standardized. So we can conclude that this organization is very good, this institute is very good, because that is having ISO standard. So this 9000 standard is associated with government organization, educational institutes, banking, telecommunication, software development companies, agricultural and manufacturing companies. Then what is the history of ISO? So ISO standard developed in 1987. It is specialized by the international agency. And more than 160 countries are using this standard. So again, after 1987, there is some revision happens in that standard in 1994 and 2000, and it again revised in 2008, and currently we are using that two standards, ISO 9000 and ISO 9001 standard. So in again ISO 9000 standard, there are again different versions. So in ISO 9000, again 2015, that standard is called as quality management systems. So in that, we check that in the software quality, all the requirements are fulfilled or not, and that's qualities of that software we check in this standard. And if we find ISO 9001 2015 standard software, then that software is fulfill all the requirements and having the best qualities. So like that, there are different ISO standards, 9004, 2009. So this standard manage the sustained success of organization. So how that standard checks, it evaluates and checks the continuous improvement process of that system. Then again, ISO 9011 to 2011, that standard is used for auditing purpose. So it has given the guidelines for auditing the management systems. Then we see the different quality management principles that are divided into the major 8 categories. So in diagram, that all the 8 categories is given. First is the customer focus. So when we check the quality, first is the you have to take care of your customer. What is the focus, actual focus of customer? Which are the qualities that customer want? So we have to focus on that customer and we have to fulfill all the needs of the customer. Then second principle is leadership. All the team has to work and incorporate all the qualities in that software. So team effort is very important. And third is the involvement of people. Your team must be active. All people must be involved in that team so that all the defects must be detected, and in improved version, your software is nearby the perfect product. The next process approach. So we have to give some deadlines, and in that deadlines, our process must be complete. Then next, system approach to management. So when you develop a software, you must have approval from the management. When you do its architecture, or when you start a designing, or when you start the coding, when you use some design patterns in that, the team must want the approval from the management so that they can start working on that. Then continual improvement. So when you create any product or any software, then when customer use that software, again that customer can recognize, can find some defects. Then in next version we can improve that. That is the continual improvement process. Next, factual approach to decision making. So sometimes we incorporate the quality in the software, so that time we have to take some decisions. So that decisions we have to take in team meeting, so that what is the final decision is of whole team, not of single person. And last is the mutual beneficial supplier relationships. So what is this mutual beneficial supplier relationships? Can anyone tell? Yes? Can anyone tell mutually beneficial supplier relationships? Your relationship must be good with everyone, so that working happens in smooth manner. Then SQA plan. So in plan there are 6 to 7 sections. First is the management section, second is the document section, third is the different standards are used, which are the different practices, conventions are used in that software quality assurance. Fourth is the review and audit of, for that section is reserved. Then fifth section is test section, how testing happens. Sixth is the problem or reporting and corrective actions are taken. So that is mentioned in the sixth section. And last section is related with the other important concepts, or which are the other important plans which we use in SQA. So this is for this SQA software quality assurance. So today we stop here. Thank you for patiently listening my lecture. Type your name in chat so that I can mark your attendance.